When this series started, the two things they said about the Bulls were they were old and they were tired, which obviously had nothing to do with what was going to happen in the future.
Well, I mean, that's true. You know, we are old. And sure, we're tired. It's been a long season. But mentally, we have a vision. We have a finish that we have to attain, you know. And sometimes you have to do it when you're old and you're tired, you know. And I think it's the test of your will to succeed when you have to deal with, you know, some of these negatives. And I'm pretty sure, you know, by the end of this playoffs, you'll see the old and the tired people were very, very young and strong mentally.
Your confidence as a team really didn't wane.
Alright, what's going on guys, the Ball Believer back here with another video, and in today's video we are talking about the one Michael Jordan story that has never been told. Now before I get in the video, I just want to make sure you guys give a like on this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on post notifications to get a new notification every time we upload a new video. Alright, now this story is the best story about Michael Jordan that was actually cut from the Last Dance documentary and has not been told. Now with just two episodes into the Last Dance program by ESPN, there's definitely a whole lot of stories that no one really knew about, and it definitely uncovered a whole lot of gems that are definitely interesting to see. Now Michael Jordan obviously had one of the greatest NBA careers of all time, winning 6 championships, 5 MVPs, and a whole lot of other accolades to go along with that. But this story actually takes place back in high school. Now as many of you know, Michael Jordan's sophomore year, he was actually cut from the Emsley A. Laney High School basketball team. And Michael at that time was definitely devastated about that. Now Michael stood at 5'10", and actually they had told him he was too small and not skilled enough to really play on the team. Now obviously Michael used this as fuel, but the untold gap in this story is actually his rise to fame between sophomore year and senior year of high school. Now Michael at the time was not being heavily recruited by a lot of college coaches, because at this point no coaches were coming to come see high school kids in Wilmington, North Carolina, which definitely wasn't a popular place to recruit at the time. Now Michael Jordan's coach actually took it upon himself and began to inflate his stats in order to help him to get into 5-star basketball camps where he could actually go ahead and show off his game and show that he could really play with the best of the best. Now at the time, Michael's parents were not too well off, so they could only afford a week of him to go to these basketball camps. In that first week, Michael had actually got the chance to play against people like Patrick Ewing, Len Bias, and other great basketball players whose names are well established now. Now that week, Michael actually ended up getting the MVP of the entire camp, which blew everybody away. They actually ended up begging him to stay for a second week, and when Michael told them that they couldn't afford another week, they actually ended up paying for him to go to those camps. Now Michael got MVP that second week, and the rest is really history. He ended up attending North Carolina, where he had a great career and became an NBA legend. Now it's definitely very interesting to see this part of the story was left out, because I think not too many people really know about this story, and it's basically how Michael Jordan and his coach really finessed their way into the camps to get him that opportunity. But definitely when he got that opportunity, he showed out and showed he could play. Now I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Just want to make sure you guys give a like on this video, comment down below your thoughts, and if you knew this story and what you really think about Michael blowing up and really making a name for himself out of those basketball camps. Subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications to get a new notification every time I upload a new video. It's Ball Believer and I'm out.